All right, it's Glenn back here at the job site. We're now gonna load the ceiling. Now, if you notice, there's the long ones and the short ones. The short ones are butt joints, where the flat ends come together. And the long ones are where the boards are on the long end, and at the edge, there's a bevel. So now, if you notice, I've taped it, and you'll notice there's mud between here and here, so there's a, it's called a filled bevel, bevel's filled. So I don't really need to stuff this full of mud, but because it is on the ceiling and we have light coming across it, we're gonna want to make it a little bit wider than normal. So now here we have a butt joint, and if you notice, you put your, take your, if you wanna ever see how things are flat, on the flat part, it won't move, but on the joint, there's space on either side. So we're gonna have to fill that space in between here and here with at least two, if not three, 12-inch trowel. Okay, so we're gonna go one side. We're actually gonna go with three. We're gonna go one in the middle here, like this. We're gonna go one on the side. One on the other side. Okay. Now, what we want to do now is fill the edges. And we can bring another one in the middle here and just smooth it out a couple of times. So that's how you do a short butt joint. Now we're going to move over to this next one over here. Okay, moving on to this next butt joint here. Again, you can see there's a gap here. So we're going to want to do three. So we take our trowel, our hawk, and go upside down. It's not going to fall off. You need to take a nice big scoop and press it along the ceiling like that, almost flat. Another one next to it here, and another one on this side here. Okay, so now we can go and feather the edge. Feather the edge, a chunk there, so we have to do it again, and down the middle. When you're up here, you see any screws that need to be done, do those at the same time. All right. Okay, we're gonna do it one more time, just to show you here. One down the middle. One on each side. Working over a table here, which isn't exactly easy. Okay, feather the edge. Feather the edge. And down the middle. Now, if you can see the tape here, which you can, you need more mud. You want to bury the tape. You don't want to be able to see the tape, because when you sand, there we go. We sand that off a little bit for your polishing coat. If you don't have enough mud on and you can see the tape, once you sand it a few times, the tape will come through and that's no good. All right, so now we're gonna do a few more of the screws. Quickly, you can take two screws at a time. That way you know your second coat. Now, that's how we load the butt joints.